We have seen the different sources of drugs. Now the remaining part we will continue up to the animal kingdom. We have completed plant kingdom. We have completed then nozules, sarcodes, and the mineral kingdom. We have completed the only part that is the Impounderabilia synthetic source is remained. So today we will start with Impounderabilia with the potentization. And we have in the first session we have completed potentization. Now we will take the remaining part of these sources of drug, because on that day it is not possible to complete. So today, as the potentization topic is very short, so we will continue our session with the remaining part of the sources of drug. So in that sources of drug, the Impounderabilia means which is not viable. Actually, this Impounderabilia is also completed, but we will take a short revision of it and then we will move further. The word Impounderabilia has come from Impounderabil, that means which is not available, that is the substance which have no perceptile weight, or the we can say we cannot weigh it. It is a non-weighable. There are the immaterial powers are there, or the energy, the medicines prepared from energies available from natural and the physical reaction, it is called Impounderabilia. So in Impounderabilia, these are the medicines which are not directly prepared from crude drug substance, but here we are using energies. It may be the natural or it may be the physical reactions. Different forms of energy are important. Source of important medicine. They are electromagnetic. They may be electrical. They may be magnetic. They may be nuclear. They may be gravitational. They may be thermal. They may be electrostatic, or they may be of cosmic energy. So this is the Impounderabilia. So these are the certain examples of Impounderabilia. But before that, we will take what the other authors have said about this. Dr. Hahnemann mentioned this in the 280 aphorism. H.C. Allen also has described this preparation of mother tincture in his Materia Medica of Nozodes. Then the Elizabeth also mentioned it, but these are not in the paper. You have write down the different source. I have asked you the different sources of nozodes. So there also you have written the authors, but these are not the sources. Sources means from where you are collecting that drug substance. So these are the views of that pioneers. For example, Dr. Hahnemann mentioned this in the footnote of aphorism number 280. Even Impounderabilia agencies can produce most violent medicinal effect upon man. So this is the theory of Dr. Hahnemann for that Impounderabilia. This is not the source of Impounderabilia. So whenever this nozode ke source agar aapko likhne hai, so you have to write down N1, N2, N3 and N4 like this. That's why I'm taking in this Impounderabilia. P. Shankaran in his book also he mentioned the sources or the importance of that Impounderabilia. Now these are the example. So first one is the soul, that is the sun rays, that is a natural energy. Luna, so luna means the moon power we are taking, full moon generally we are taking, and the light of that full moon, from that we are preparing medicine. The next one is magnetis polyombo. This magnetis, it is produced with the help of magnetic energy. Then the magnetic polus Arcturus. So this is the north pole of magnet. Magnetis polus Australis, that is the south pole of magnet. Magnetis artificiality, that is the magnetic energy we are using, both the poles we are using here. Then X-ray, radium bromide and electricity. So here we are using the electricity It may be the static electricity or it may be the atmospheric electricity. So these are the certain examples of imponderable. So next is the synthetic sources. So synthetic source means this is not a factopathy, this is the tactopathy. These are artificial human made preparations. Firstly, included by Dr. K.P. Mazumdar. These contain preparations made from commonly used allopathic medicines and generally prepared at physician or prescriber level. So this is the tactopathy, or this is the method by which we are transforming the allopathic medicines into the homeopathic medicine by doing the trituration. So tactopathy is a method of curing for removing the bad effects of side effects of drug by intoxication, that is curing by means of identical harmful agent in the potentized form. For example, if you are having the bad effect of any antibiotic, then the theory is like that when you are giving in the form of potency, or you are giving the potentized form, then this will remove the bad effect. That is known as a tactopathy. This form of source of those medicines which are taken from synthetic and chemical products. So here there are the certain examples of this synthetic source. So I will read here only the five examples are given, but I will explain you the different medicines which are given in the synthetic source. So they are actazolamide or the actohexamide, amoxicillin or the Benadryl, Benadryl penicillin, then the butazolidine, then carbamazepine, then cefotaxime or the chloroquine, then the cortisone, then the dopamine. So these are the certain medicines, or the histamine, paracetamol, also there, streptomycin, then certain sulfa drugs are also included, and tetramycin. So these are the certain drugs. If you are taking these drugs, there may be the certain side effects. So to avoid these side effects, we are giving this in the form of potency or in the potentized form, so that it will remove the bad effects of this medicine. Because when you are taking the HCQ or the chloroquine, the sugar level decreases. And for that we have the certain instructions are given by the doctor, so that there should be the balance of this sugar level. So to remove this bad effect, we can give it in the potentized form. So these are the imponderable and the synthetic source of the medicine. The next source that we will see that is included in the recent advances of homeopathy, that is the aller source. So aller source are homeopathic attenuations of antigen, that is a substance which under a suitable condition can stimulate the formulation of antibodies. So the new addition of the drugs, that is the aller source. So these aller source, the attenuations are prepared from the antigen. That is a substance which is under a suitable condition. So ye kya hai? That antigen will stimulate the antibodies regarding that particular disease. So antigen kaun se lete hain? So antigen includes the these antigens may be agglutinins, or it may be the hydrogens, it may be the venoms, it may be the agglutinins. So these are the certain examples of the attenuation or the antigen. We are doing the potentization and we are preparing the medicine of it. And this medicine will trigger the antibodies. Technically, allosaurs are the subset of the idiopathic remedies. It may be dispensed in the attenuation which are below 6x or 3c. Again, we will take it in the recent advances of homeopathy. And the isoles, these are the homeopathic medicines which are prepared from plant, animal or chemical substances, including drugs, excipients or binders, which have been ingested or otherwise absorbed by the body and are believed to have produced a disease or disorder which interfere with homeostasis. Those may be called dextrose. This also contains the preparation made from commonly used allopathic medicines. Those are prepared as per HPI, that is the Indian Homeopathic Pharmacopoeia. Those are prepared generally at physician prescriber level. Generally, isoles are not used below the 6x potency. Awareness of the side effects of the drug and the lower attenuation is up to 6x is very essential. So the examples are the eucalyptus oil or the gelatin or the ibuprofen or the isoniazid. These are the certain examples of the isoles. So these allosaurs and the isoles, we are preparing this medicine with the help of the allopathic medicine. So these allosaurs, we are preparing with the help of antigens, the substances which is suitable to the substance which under a suitable condition can produce the formation of antibodies. And these antigens include certain toxins. It may be the lysogen, it may be the venins, it may be the agglutinins, it may be the complements, it may be the opposons. So opposonogens. So these are the certain things which triggers the antibodies in our body. And the isoles, these are prepared from the plant and animal or the certain chemical substances. Again, we have to do the potentization. This may contains the certain allopathic medicines, but we are preparing it according to the homeopathic pharmacopoeia of India, and their potency is not exceeding more than the 6C, or it should not be exceed more than the 3X. So there are the certain recent advances in the homeopathy also, where we are using the different sources that other than these we have discussed previously. So these all comes in the recent advances of the homeopathy. Again, the manufacturing techniques are also changes nowadays. We are using the machines for the potentization. Then we are also doing the microscopical examination of the plant drug. We are also studying the stomata of that leaf, whether it is healthy or not. Then we are also doing the quantitative microscopy. We are all doing the small tests for the quality control of the crude drug substance as well as the mother tincture and for the potency. So these all will come under the recent advances, but in the sources of drug you can add this. So previously it is only up to the synthetic sources, but in these two sources you can add allosaurs and the this isoles. So these are the certain examples or the allosaurs and the nozo. So again, we will take in short this vegetable kingdom, animal kingdom, sources of drug, and these animal source, vegetable source, mineral kingdom, sarcodes, impunderabilia, synthetic source, allosaurs and the isoles. These are the sources of homeopathic drug. In the vegetable kingdom, we have seen all the things, whole plant, with examples. We have seen the medicine prepared from roots, hanging roots, aerial root, roots and rhizome, stem. Then again we have seen the certain examples like burl, rhizome, etc. From the medicines which are prepared from leaves, from the young shoots, from fruits, from the pulp, from bark. Animal kingdom, we have seen the lot many of things in the animal kingdom. Here are the certain examples of that animal kingdom. In the mineral kingdom also, we have seen the certain acids, organic, inorganic things. We have seen the metals, we have seen the non-metals. All these things we have completed. Again, the nozores, that is the biotherapeutic preparation. I have explained the word biotherapeutic. Here are the certain bio means which is related to the living organism or the living animal. And here are the certain examples. And here we are using the disease product of that living organism. We are potentizing it and preparing the medicine. For example, sorinum. So we are taking the discharge from the psoriasis and preparing the medicine. Pyrogenum, dipterinum, and about bad effect, we can say the disadvantage is that whenever there is no discharge, we cannot prepare that nozole. And in the proving also, I have explained you that the proving of nozole is the today's research work, because it is not totally proved on the healthy human beings. And again, I have told you the one point that to know the organic changes, we are now taking the permission to prove it on the lower organism, so that we will also get the pathological changes. So this is about the nozores. Then sarcodes, they are prepared from the protoplasm of animals. It is highly useful in the homeopathy. It is also called as organotherapy. So we are using here the fresh discharges. Examples: imponderabilia, that is the non-variable substances. Here we are using the energies. Here we are using the rays to prepare the medicine directly. We are not using the crude drug substance. So we are using here electricity, magnetic power, nuclear energy, sun rays, moon rays, etc. Here are the certain examples. Here we are using the sun rays, then moon rays, then magnetic energy, then the X-ray, radium bromide, and the electricity. Synthetic source, that is the tattoopathy, the medicines which are prepared from the allopathy. We are doing the potentization and we are preparing medicine. The next source is the, and these are the examples of synthetic source. The next one is the aller source, that is we are preparing the medicine from the antigen. We are doing the potentization, but the risk is that it should not be exceed than the 6x or the 3c. Next is the isotopes. Here we are using the chemicals or the drug excipients or the binders. Again, we are doing the potentization, and we can use in the homeopathy to remove the bad effects of the that particular drug. Again, the lower attenuation should be used up to 3x. So these are the certain sources of drug. Deena, please. Hall madhe. These allosource and isosource, we will take it again in the recent advances of homeopathy. Okay. So if you have any doubt regarding this allosource, isosource, or imipenem or anything, you can ask me anytime. Because the recent advances are nowadays important, and a lot of research work is going on in it. So if you have any problem, you can ask.